So we are starting with the transition elements, our 8th unit of the 12th class, transition elements. And inner transition elements. Other name of this chapter is D and F block elements. So we are doing important questions of this unit. First question is define transition elements. So what are transition elements? These are the elements of D block. In these elements, it is n minus 1d subcell which is progressively filled. These elements are included in group number 3 to group number 12. So these are called as transition elements, and these elements bring a transition. From more reactive metals, they are of S block, to non-metals, they belong to P block. They are situated in between S and P block, since they are bringing a change from metals to non-metals. When we are present on left hand side of this group, we are having metals of S block, alkali metal and alkaline earth metals. When I go to right hand side, there will be P block. So this is their position. This is S block in the beginning, then we have D block, and then we have P block, and below we are having F block. So this is our first question, what are transition elements? There is another definition of transition elements. The elements which have partially filled n minus 1d subcell in their ions. So elements which have partially filled n minus 1d subcell in their ions, they are also called as transition elements or d block elements. Then there is a very important question, why zinc, cadmium and mercury, Zn, Cd and mercury are not regarded as transition elements. Answer is, if we see the second definition, these elements must possess partially filled n minus d orbitals in their ionic state. When we see Zn 2 positive ion, cadmium 2 positive ion and mercury 2 positive ion, they all have filled d subcell. It has 3d filled d subcell, it will be having 4d filled d subcell, it will be having 5d subcell. So answer, due to filled d subcells in ionic state, that is plus 2 state, in plus 2 ionic state, Zn 2 positive le, cadmium 2 positive le, ya hum le mercury 2 positive, all of them they possess filled d subcells, so they do not follow the definition. That's why these elements, they are not regarded as transition elements. Since they are ions, they don't have partially filled d subcell. Then we have another question, very important question. What are inner transition elements? As we have written in the unit, name of the unit is transition elements. and inner transition element. So our question number 3 is define inner transition elements or epoch elements. So as the name suggests, inner transition element, these are the elements which might be situated inner to the transition elements, and this is the case. In order to prevent the expansion of periodic table, these elements, they have been placed at the bottom of the periodic table, just below S, P, D and F block. S, P and D block, they are placed at the bottom. There are two series of these elements. First series is called as lanthanoid series, which is also called as 4F series, and second series is called as actinide series, which is also called as 5F series. Since in these elements it is N minus 2F subcell which is progressively filled, that's why they are also called as F block elements and inner transition elements. So these are the elements. Situated actually inner to transition elements, but to avoid unwanted expansion of periodic table, they have been placed at the bottom of periodic table. Since in them N minus 2F subcell is progressively filled, so they are also called as epoch elements. There are two series of 14 elements each. First series is lanthanoids or 4F series, and second is actinoids, or it is called as 5F series. So there are two series of epoch element, 4F series and 5F series. Now we come to another important question, that is question number 4. Give preparation of KMnO4 from pyrolusite. Pyrolusite, it is a important ore of manganese. Give preparation of KMnO4 from pyrolusite. Pyrolusite is MnO2. So how to prepare MnO2? You take MnO2, along with that you heat it with 4KOH plus O2. Heat it, you will get 2K2MnO4. For this you have to take 2MnO2. Along with that you will have 2H2. Oxygen is to be adjusted. 10 oxygen here, 4 and 4, 8. So 10 oxygens are here. So this reaction got balanced. Now K2MnO4 can be changed into KMnO4. So you take 2K2MnO4, it is heated with chlorine, you will get 2KCl along with 2KMnO4. Similarly, you can also convert it by taking ozone and water, you will get 2KOH plus 2KMnO4 plus O2. oxygen is counted 8, 3, 11, 12 oxygens are there, 2, 10 and 12 oxygens are there. So this is the conversion of K to MnO4. It can be done by electrolytic method. Yeah, K to MnO4 is electrolyzed, it will be ionized to give you 2K positive plus MnO4 negative. At cathode, 2K positive, it neutralizes its charge by taking electrons. At anode, steel anode is used here, MnO4 to negative loses one electron and changes into MnO4 negative. So this is done in the presence of water, then H2O will also ionize to give you H positive and OH negative ion, and this 2H positive will be now converted into H2, and in solution you will left with K positive and MnO4 ions. They combine to give you KMnO4. So this reaction has to be changed at 2H positive ion. Here they are changing into the, in the presence of water, they are changing into hydrogen gas. So this is the preparation of KMnO4 by means of pyrolusite. Pyrolusite is an important ore of manganese, which is on heating with potassium hydroxide and oxygen, or heating with your K2CO3, it can be changed into K2MnO4, that is called as potassium manganate. Potassium manganate can be changed into potassium permanganate by three ways we have shown you. Then we have why more, question number fifth, why most of the transition ions and transition metals atoms are paramagnetic in nature. We have already studied paramagnetism in the solid state, that the species, the substances which are having unpaired electron in their atoms or ions, they have net magnetic moment on their orbitals. That's why these substances, when they are placed in a magnetic field, they are definitely attracted by that applied magnetic field, and such substances they are called as paramagnetic substances. So paramagnetism, it is associated with presence of unpaired electrons in N-1D and NS subshell of these atoms and ions. So these atoms oblique ions have net magnetic moment on their orbitals when they are placed in magnetic field. They get attracted towards it. This is known as paramagnetism. The effective magnetic moment can be calculated by formula mu effective, effective magnetic moment, that is equal to n plus 2, that is expressed in Bohr magneton. Now what is n here? n is the number of unpaired electron present in a metal atom or ion. For example, we have copper 2 positive ion. Copper 2 positive ion, this will have the configuration 20 2 9 2. It will be having configuration argon 3d9. Argon atomic number is 18 plus 9 27. Now it has how many unpaired electrons? Let us see. 5d orbitals, 2 in the first 4d orbital, 1 electron is left unpaired, so n value is here 1. Put here n 1 1 plus 2, it is under root 3. This is 1.732. This is Bohr magnetone. This is the magnetic moment of copper positive ions. So once you are given an ion, you have to calculate how many unpaired electron it has. You have not to see the total number of electron in the d subshell. That number is 9 here. We cannot put the value here 9. Unpaired electron can be maximum up to 5. They will not be more than that. So how it can be 9? So then you have to see how many pairs of the electrons are formed, how many unpaired electrons are left. The number of unpaired electrons, that has to be counted, that has to be seen, and that is used to calculate effective magnetic moment of that transition metal ion or atom. Then we come to another question. Out of Cu positive and Cu2 positive, which one will be more stable and why? Cu2 positive, copper 2 positive ion is formed after loss of 2 electrons from copper atom, and Cu positive is formed by after loss of 1 electron from the configuration. So we have question, out of Cu positive and Cu2 positive, which one is stable, more stable and colored? For this type of question, we have to see the electronic configuration. Cu2 positive will have configuration we have just seen. It will have argon core and 3d9, 4s is 0 here. Then we have Cu positive, it has the configuration Ar3d10, 4s 0. So seeing the electronic configuration, this is more stable because it has completely filled d subshell. And seeing the color will be shown by Cu2 positive ion, since it has 1n-1d electron in unpaired state. And capable of showing d-d transition by absorbing some colors from visible light and reflecting other colors. Which become the color of this ion? So Cu2 positive appears blue in the aqueous state. It is due to d-d transition, and Cu positive would not show any color because its electrons are paired and more energy, very high energy is required to show the transition from 3d subshell to 4d subshell. In this case, the electron transition that is easy as compared to this subshell, so it shows color. Then we have the question, draw the structure of salt MnO4 negative and Cr2O72 negative. If we see MnO4 negative, 3 oxygen, they are doubly bonded, and 1 oxygen is negatively charged. So it is capable of showing resonance. In another structure, it will be having other oxygen negative, all the other three oxygen they are positive, so it will go on changing. And in another structure, it will be negative charge will be lying on the lowest oxygen. So it is a resonance hybrid of these structures. Then we have Cr2O7, two negative. This is like this CrO, Cr, O, O, O. If it is having two negative charge and one oxygen, can be shown negatively charged. So this negative charge can be stabilized on this oxygen, this oxygen, this, this, this. So it can also undergo six resonating structure and can be the resonance hybrid of those six structures. Then we have very important question from the transition metals. It is often asked in the exam. Now, what is lanthanoid contraction and what is its cause and what are the consequences of lanthanoid contraction? So we want to see what is lanthanoid contraction and what are the causes of lanthanoid contraction and what are the consequences. Question number 8 is define lanthanoid contraction. Give its cause and consequences. Answer: lanthanoid contraction, LC, it is defined as the contraction in the atomic sizes of the elements which follow lanthanum. जो लैंथेनम के बाद एलिमेंट आते हैं, दीज आर द एलिमेंट्स ऑफ एक्चुअली 4F सीरीज, दे शो कंट्रैक्शन इन देयर एटॉमिक साइजेस. व्हाई दिस कंट्रैक्शन इज सीन, लेट अस फर्स्ट नो व्हाट एलिमेंट कम आफ्टर लैंथेनम. फॉर दिस यू कैन कीप इन माइंड लेसी पर नड पम सम यू गड टब डाई हो इनतम यब्लू. यू कैन मेमोराइज दिस एलिमेंट लाइक दिस. इट विल बी अंडर 3, इट इज 57, देन वी हैव अंडर 2, 101, 100, 100, 99, 98, 97, 96, 95, 94, 93, 92. So these are the elements which follow lanthanum. So after lanthanum there is a gap of 14 elements and then we get this element. So here atomic number will be different. You will be having 73 74 75 76 77 78 81 82 83 84 85 86. It should like this. So these are the elements which follow lanthanum. The size of these elements that decreases. Why it decreases? It mainly decreases because of the, you can say, it will decrease because of the atomic numbers are to be connected here. Let us correct the atomic numbers, they are not like that. Lanthanum, lesi, per, nut, pum, sum, you, gird, tub, I ho, here tam yablu. This is 57, 58 in continuity. You will be reaching 71 here. 59, 60, 61, 62, 63, 64, 65, 67, 68, 69, and 70 and 71. In this element, 4 F's of cell it is filled up. Now, what is the cause of lanthanoid contraction? It is the poor shielding effect of 4 F's of cells. The electrons which are entering in the 4 F's of cell, their shape is a scattered shape, and they don't help to reduce the nuclear force on the valence electron. That's why the sizes of these elements that go on decreasing, because nuclear force is not decreased, that is not reduced by the intervening electron, which are 4F electrons. That's why size becomes smaller, and due to lanthanoid contraction, their chemical properties, they become similar, and their separation become difficult since their properties are similar. So causes of lanthanoid contraction is their properties almost become similar, their electronegativity almost become similar, ionization energy becomes similar, the basic strength of the hydroxide is not affected much on moving from left to right, sizes of 4D and 5D series element that becomes almost similar. Then we have the next question, why zinc, cadmium and mercury? No enthalpies of sublimation. So reason is very much clear. They have filled D subcells. They don't have partially filled D subcell, which the electrons of which subcell can be easily entered into a metallic bonding. So since they are having filled D subcells, so their metallic bonding will be weak, and since they have no metallic bonding, weak metallic bonding and weak metal forces, moreover no covalent bonds are formed by the overlapping of partially filled d orbitals, since they don't have those orbitals. So when metallic bonding is weak, there is no formation of covalent bond, since they don't have the partially filled n minus d subcell, and van der Waals forces, they are also weak. So all these three factors, they reduce their enthalpy of sublimation as well as enthalpy of vaporization. That's why these elements also have the low boiling points also. Then we have why transition element, they form alloys. This is our question number 10. Why transition elements form alloys? Answer is, it is due to their similar sizes, almost they have similar sizes. So atoms of one element can be easily fitted into the lattice of another element. That's why when two elements, they are changed into liquid and they are mixed together, the atoms of these elements, they easily rearrange among themselves and they give the stable lattice of the two elements combined together in a very stable position, and the quality of these alloys, they are very much modified, they have better quality than the pure elements. So why they form alloys, the reason is very much clear, that their sizes are similar, so they can easily mix up with each other and forms variety of alloys by mixing together. And these alloys, they are largely used in our commercial industry. Thank you very much.